Back so soon? You couldn't wait to hear about the last five in the Bill of Rights? Well then, let's go! So if you missed the last episode, check it out down in the comments. In that video, I go over the first five amendments in the Bill of Rights. These are the ones that protect you from most things the government can do. Just a quick review: freedom of speech, religion, press, petition, and assembly, freedom to own guns, freedom to not have soldiers hang out in your house, freedom to be secure in all your stuff without a search warrant, and freedom not to be tried for the same crime twice or have to confess against yourself. Wow, that was pretty fast, actually. Proud of myself. Amendment 6. In all criminal prosecutions, the accused shall enjoy the right to a speedy and public trial by an impartial jury of the state and district wherein the crime shall have been committed, which district shall have been previously ascertained by law, and to be informed of the nature and the cause of the accusation, to be confronted with the witnesses against him, to have compulsory process for obtaining witnesses in his favor, and to have the assistance of counsel for his defense. So, Amendment 6 covers the fact that if you're accused of a crime, you have the right to a trial in a timely manner. You can't be locked up for decades before they put you on trial. And you have the right to a jury, which hopefully has no opinion of your guilt or innocence before they hear the case. Additionally, the trial for the said crime that you supposedly committed must be in the location where the crime actually happened, so that it is near those who are affected by it. You also have the right to know who is accusing you of the crime. And finally, you have the right to confront your accuser and provide witnesses for your own defense in this case. Additionally, you have the right to a lawyer if you need one. Amendment 7. In suits at common law, where the value in controversy shall exceed $20, the right of trial by jury shall be preserved, and no fact tried by a jury shall be otherwise re-examined in any court of the United States than according to the rules of common law. So, basically, if you're in court for a non-criminal matter, you have the right to a jury if you want one. Think of like lawsuits against big companies. There may or may not have been a crime, but they can still have a jury listen to the case. Amendment 8. Excessive bail shall not be required, nor excessive fines imposed, nor cruel and unusual punishment inflicted. So, if you were arrested for a petty crime, you stole a candy bar, they can't hit you with a bail of $2 million because that's way in excess of the actual crime. Additionally, they can't hit you with a cruel and unusual punishment. So if you stole that candy bar, they can't cut your hands off. Amendment 9. The enumeration of the Constitution of certain rights shall not be construed to deny or disparage others retained by the people. The Constitution can't be used to take away rights from people. So, just because it's not listed in the Constitution doesn't mean it's not a right you still have. Amendment 10. The powers not delegated to the United States by the Constitution, nor prohibited by it to the states, are reserved to the states respectively, or to the people. Any power that's not directly given to the Constitution is up to your states. So if it's not mentioned here, it's up to the states to decide. This amendment was built in to help the anti-federalists feel a little bit better that states still get some power. If the federal government doesn't say you can do it, and the state doesn't say you can't do it, then you can do it. The 10th Amendment allows you to have powers. So if the federal government doesn't care and the state doesn't care, it falls to the local government, to the towns, the cities, the county, the whatever. And if they don't care, then it falls to a right that the people have to do what they please. So out of these five amendments, the second half of the Bill of Rights, do any of these outweigh the necessity or the power of the first five? What do you think? Let me know down in the comments below. If you like what you've seen, click like. If you want to see more of what I got new videos every Monday, so hit subscribe to make sure that you catch them. Ring the bell so that you don't miss any notifications. Thanks for watching Learning with Sprayberry, where we make social studies fun, easy, and educational.